Identity politics, also called identitarian politics, refers to political positions based on the interests and perspectives of social groups with which people identify. Identity politics includes the ways in which people's politics may be shaped by aspects of their identity through loosely correlated social organizations. Examples include social organizations based on race, gender identity, ethnicity, nationality, sexual orientation, disability, religion, culture, language and dialect. Not all members of any given group are involved in identity politics. The term identity politics came into being during the latter part of the 20th century, during the civil rights era. During this time period, identity politics were used by a minority group to form a coalition with members of the majority. Now the term is popularly used when referring to nationalist movements. The term identity politics has been used in political discourse since at least the 1970s. One aim of identity politics has been for those feeling oppressed to articulate their felt oppression in terms of their own experience by a process of consciousness raising. For example, in their germinal statement of Black Feminist Identity Politics, the Combahee River Collective said that as children we realized that we were different from boys and that we were treated different, for example, when we were told in the same breath to be quiet both for the sake of being ladylike and to make us less objectionable in the eyes of white people. In the process of consciousness raising, actually life sharing, we began to recognize the commonality of our experiences and, from the sharing and growing consciousness, to build a politics that will change our lives and inevitably end our oppression. Identity politics as a mode of organizing is closely connected to the concept that some social groups are oppressed, such as women, ethnic minorities, sexual minorities, etc. That is, individuals belonging to those groups are by virtue of their identity more vulnerable to forms of oppression such as cultural imperialism, violence, exploitation, marginalization, or powerlessness. Identity politics starts from analyses of oppression to recommend a restructuring of the existing society. Identity politics is a phenomenon that arose first at the radical margins of liberal democratic societies in which human rights are recognized, and the term is not usually used to refer to dissident movements within single-party or authoritarian states. The elements of identity politics can be seen to be present in many of the earliest statements of feminists, ethnic movements, and gay and lesbian liberation. Formally, it may even be taken back to Marx's earliest statements about a class becoming conscious of itself and developing a class identity. Class identity politics were first described briefly in an article by L.A. Kaufman, who traced its origins to the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, SNCC, an organization of the civil rights movements in the USA in the early and mid-1960s. Although SNCC invented many of the fundamental practices, and various Black Power groups extended them, they apparently found no need to apply a term. Rather, the term emerged when others outside the Black freedom movements, particularly the race and ethnic-specific women's liberation movements, such as Black feminism, began to adopt the practice in the late 1960s. Traces of identity politics can also be found in the early writings of the modern gay movement such as Dennis Altman's Homosexual, Liberation/Oppression, Jeffrey Weeks' Coming Out, Homosexual Politics in Britain from the 19th Century to the Present, and Ken Plummer's Ed the Making of the Modern Homosexual. One of the older written examples of it can be found in the Combahee River Collective Statement of April 1977, subsequently reprinted in a number of anthologies, and Barbara Smith and the Combahee River Collective have been credited with coining the term, which they defined as a politics that grew out of our objective material experiences as Black women. Some groups have combined identity politics and Marxist social class analysis and class consciousness, the most notable example being the Black Panther Party, but this is not necessarily characteristic of the form. Another example is MOVE, who mixed Black nationalism with anarcho-primitivism, a radical form of green politics based on the idea that civilization is an instrument of oppression, advocating a return to hunter-gatherer society and the related idea neoluddism. During the 1980s, the politics of identity became very prominent and was linked with new social movement activism. Regarding the Donald Trump presidential campaign, Connor Friedersdorf speculated in the August 2016 issue of The Atlantic the Republicans might become a party of white identity politics. The identification of some voters to the protection of a white majority and traditional white values sometimes masked as nationalism has increased the prospect of white identity politics. White identity politics can be driven by demographic change and diversity. Increased diversity and the prospect of whites becoming a minority in America can drive many to affiliate with conservative causes, including those not related to diversity.